Okay, so after the install of stock Klipper on the V400, I was having an issue with the Wi-Fi. So the speeder pad would display it as being connected to my Wi-Fi, and it will even show an IP address, but it just wouldn't work. I can't connect to it, I can't go into SSH. I will have to come into the network panel and then turn the network off and on, or I have to click reconnect to my Wi-Fi. And then that would allow me to use the Wi-Fi after a code boot. I've done a lot of tests and I don't know what the issue is, but basically I wrote a script that automated turning the network off and on at boot. And so then I wouldn't have come in manually to click this because the networking page on the V400 is quite unresponsive on the new update. Go into SSH. Then I made a script, sudo nano startup.sh. You can call wherever you want. I just called it startup.sh. It has to end in .sh because it's a shell script. And then so the first line just tells the OS that this is a bash script. And then nmcli networking off. Nm is network manager. So this just turns network manager off. Waits for 5 seconds and then turns network manager back on. And something you have to be aware of is that if you turn network manager off and you forget to turn it back on, then there's really no way to turn it back on. Because once you turn it off, the printer will disconnect from your network. And then on your printer, the network page is not going to work because the network manager is turned off. And there's no way to turn it on from the speeder pad, or not that I know of. Okay, so if you give the command networking off, make sure you give the command networking on afterwards. So once you type these few lines in, you press Control X and it'll say, do you want to save? You just press Y and then it'll ask you where to save. Just press Enter. So that's the script that runs at startup. But you have to give it permissions so that it can execute. And so the permission, you have to change it by giving sudo chmod plus x and then the file name, so startup.sh. And once you've done that, you can double check if you've done it correctly by going ls-l. And so then you will look for your script, startup.sh or whatever your script name is called, and you want to see that it has 3x's at the front. So 1x, 2x, 3x. So now you have a script that will turn network manager off and on, and it also has the permissions to be executed. You need to add the script to the startup schedules. So there's quite a few ways of doing it, and the easiest way I found was to use rc.local. So what you're going to do is go to sudo nano -etc /rc.local. So for on your printer, you should see something like this. And so this is something that is being executed at boot. And so I can just add in another line that says sudo bash slash home slash pi slash startup.sh, and that's the location of a bash script. So startup.sh, if you didn't specify a location, it should be saved in home slash pi. Okay, and once you have that set up, just press Control X again, save modify, press Y to save the buffer, and then just press Enter. That's really all you have to do. Just make a script, give it permissions, and then add that script to the startup schedule in the RC local. And so every time your printer boots up, it will turn the network manager off and on automatically so that your Wi-Fi will work